Xiaomi Mi 11 5G is supposed to be the cheapest and least impressive model in this year's Mi 11 series. It doesn't have a powerful camera or a top-notch screen, but I think it still has some highlights that are unique to the model. For these rare highlights, I think there are still many people who will pay for it. Before I start the review, I want to make one thing clear. The Mi 11 Lite in this review is the 5G enabled Chinese version, not the 4G only global version. Its appearance at the first glance is almost identical to that of the Mi 11. It has the same lens module design, the same logo position, but the details are different. For example, the back panel has become flat, the power button has integrated fingerprint recognition, and the 108 megapixel on the lens is gone. In terms of design alone, it is very ordinary, but its biggest highlight is its weight and thickness control. 159 gram weight and 6.81 mm thickness is very rare for a 5G phone. And this is also the lightest and thinnest 5G phone we have seen. The weight of this phone plus an egg is only as much as a Mi 11 Pro. And most importantly, although the frame is still plastic, the back panel is still made of AG frosted glass. It feels much better than a phone that is entirely made of plastic. At least it won't feel so cheap. Although the Mi 11 Lite 5G design is very ordinary, I am willing to give it a high rating for this extreme weight and thickness control. The front of the Mi 11 Lite 5G features a 6.55 inch 90Hz 1080 pixel screen with HDR 10 Plus and Dolby Vision support. The bottom bezel width is well constructed and the screen is a bit like the iPhone 11 with 4 equal widths. And this straight screen is made of flexible AMOLED, so theoretically the look and feel should be good. But Mi 11 Lite's 5G comes in two types of displays in the market. Basically, the pixels are arranged in two different configurations. One variant features a screen with diamond-like pixels, while the other has RGB delta pixels. Unfortunately, the RGB delta pixel screen, where compared to the diamond-like pixels, screen has worse font clarity and the font edge has a color edge problem. The unit features a screen with RGB delta pixels, so the screen quality is low compared to the other variant that comes at the same price. And if you look at the phone screen from the side, the problem of the color cast is obvious. But if you are lucky and get a version with diamond-like pixels on the screen, I believe the screen can still score a passing grade. But the RGB delta pixels version is obviously a failing grade. The second highlight of the Mi 11 Lite 5G is the new Snapdragon 780G processor. The performance of the new 5nm Snapdragon mid-range processor is as follows. AnTuTu benchmark runs at 5377/88, 3DMark at 3121, Geekbench 5 single core at 805 and multi-core at 2937. Compared to MTK's Dimensity 1200, it is still a bit worse. The gaming test also confirms this view. PUBG seems to exert no significant pressure on the mid-range chip, running at almost full frame rate with HDR graphics extreme frame rate. However, Genshin Impact has an average frame rate of 37.96 FPS, which was a rather mediocre experience. Bridge Ridge has even worse, with an average of less than 30 frames per second. The one thing that performed better was the temperature control. The maximum temperature reached was only 50 degrees Celsius and the chip wasn't downclocked during gaming. The screen brightness wasn't forced down either. Overall, the Mi 11 Lite 5G is only suitable for light gaming users. The camera on the Mi 11 Lite 5G is a budget camera. The three cameras consist of 64 megapixel main camera, an 8 megapixel ultra-wide lens and a 5 megapixel telephoto macro lens. The color style of the main camera is on the high contrast side. The contrast is higher than the Realme GT Neo. Some scenes will look sharper, but the dynamic range is not as good. The probability of automatic HDR triggering is not high, but even if HDR is manually turned on, the dynamic range improvement is not much. When taking photos, be careful not to choose a scene that's extremely bright. The 2x zoom sharpening is too heavy. The line will appear jagged. The performance at night is similar to that of the day, with the high contrast ratio causing the night scene to look a little underexposed. But the highlights are well controlled. The highlights are further depressed in night mode, and the exposure can be slightly improved in extreme darkness. But when there is plenty of light, lowering the highlights will make your eyes uncomfortable. Unless the light is very weak, it is not recommended to use night mode to take pictures. The performance of ultra-wide angle lens is almost the same as the main camera. The main difference is that the hardware limitations led to more serious underexposure of night photos. Check out a few groups of sample photos to get an idea. The macro lens is the same as the one in the Redmi K40. I believe you are already very familiar with the strength of this telephoto macro lens. It can take some good close-up photos that the main camera and ultra-wide lens can't take. The box is still without the charger and charging cable. The charger and charging cable are still separately included. 33W charging power is also the standard configuration for the Xiaomi family of mid-range phones. In 10 minutes, it charges 24%, after half an hour, it goes to 57%, and for a full charge, it needs 64 minutes. Generally speaking, the battery capacity of thin and light phones is not very large. It is shocking that Xiaomi still managed to put in a 4,250 mAh battery into it, knowing that this is a 159-gram phone. In our test, the phone consumes 6% of half hour of TikTok and 5% of half hour of 1080p video. Two mainstream games, PUBG and Genshin Impact, consume 9% and 16% respectively. The high-load game, Bridge Ridge, consumes 10%. This battery life level is now comparable to many 4500mAh battery phones. This battery on such a light phone should be its third highlight in this review. To conclude, the Xiaomi Mi 11 5G is not a traditional Xiaomi smartphone. It doesn't have strong hardware and isn't priced very low either. In terms of hardware configuration, it doesn't even give you as much value as the Redmi K40, which is cheaper. But in the 5G era, it offers one of the few options for users who like to use light and thin phones. In fact, I would recommend you to go to an offline store and get your hands on this phone. Then you will understand its significance in Xiaomi's lineup. How you like this video, friends? I am expecting a couple of messages from your end. And friends, if you are visiting my channel for the first time, please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that whatever the latest leaked information I am revealing through my YouTube channel will get updated to you at the earliest. Thank you very much in watching this video. Catch you again with another episode of Inside Stories. Till then, stay safe, stay tuned. This is Subir. Sign off.